Basically, when you're climbing a mountain, हर पल एक टेस्ट की तरह होता है. आपको हर मोमेंट में सही फैसले लेने हैं. मुश्किल रास्तों पर, रफ टेरेन में, आपका शरीर भी आपका साथ छोड़ सकता है. आपकी सारी एनर्जी आपके गोल पे फोकस करने के अलावा आपकी बॉडी को कन्विंस करने में खत्म हो जाती है, और ये आप अफोर्ड नहीं कर सकते. Stamina building is basically a process which takes place in two directions. One is breathing, and the second one is muscle endurance. In breathing, I practice a lot of yoga, but apart from that, doing 18 kilometers of running in a week for about 5 times. There's also 70 kilometers of cycling. Then I'm also clocking another uphill running distance about 4 times in the gym. The second bit, which is the muscle endurance, I build a climbing wall in my house to simulate the same kind of stress which my muscle has to undergo while I'm climbing an 8,000 meter mountain. And I try and spend the most amount of time which I can on the wall. For the lack of oxygen on a mountain, I practice yoga every day. I practice Anulom Vilom, Kapalbhati, and basic pranic breathing. There is only a certain limit which I can reach to at the physical level, so I have to focus on my breath through yoga, through basic breathing practices. Beyond base camp, I'm going to be having to carry my minus 60 degree sleeping bag. I'll be carrying my down suit, and I'll be carrying a down jacket. There's going to be some about 10 kgs of down gear. I'll have about technical iron gear, which includes crampons, ice axes, carabiners, slings, harness, helmet. It's all going to be somewhere about another 10 kilos. I think the fourth one will be all my rations. So that will be somewhere varying about 7 to 8 kilos more. In a total, somewhere between 25 to 30 kilos is what I'll be carrying up on Kangchenjunga. Basically, when you're in the mountains, you need to have a very good knowledge bank on how to read the weather. So towards the planning, towards the end of the expedition, there's this very important phase called the summit push, where we need to access the above 8,000 meter mark on all mountains. And this has to happen in a very specific window date. So the summit window generally comes like, some years it'll come for like 2 days, 3 days, when the winds are as low before the monsoon starts hitting the mountain. That's when we know that, okay, it's now or never, we better rush up to the summit. Kanchenjunga pe khas karke the summit push is extremely long, because jo last camp hai wo 7600 meters pe lagta hai, and the highest point of this mountain is almost at 8586 meters, which is almost 8600 meters. So you almost have to gain 1000 meters in one night, which is very, very, very difficult at that altitude. This we have to cover in almost 18 hours, because beyond that, the weather will start to turn bad. As soon as the fifth afternoon starts kicking in, hopefully, हम लोगों ने कंचनजंगा के शिखर पर इंडिया का झंडा लहरा लिया होगा और हम लोग सेफली वहां से नीचे उतरना शुरू कर दिए होंगे. After 18 hours of climbing up, another 6 hours coming down, we cannot stop there anymore. So 24 hours more after 5.5 days. But up there, I think I start. These are the moments when I start feeling alive. In these moments, मुझे कुछ एक ऐसी memory याद रहती है जो मुझे यहाँ पे training में भी मुझे motivate करती है. Sometimes the mountain is so demanding. It's a slow and very, very tedious process. I want the world to remember that it does not depend on where you come from or what you have or where you are. If you're still breathing every day, you're far more luckier than most people who are dead last night. Live by this and never limit yourself. Thank you.